of Music City. It's time for Music City Roots, live from the Loveless Cafe, featuring authentic music from the roots of American culture. I'm Keith Bilbrand. We're broadcasting from the big old barn out behind the Loveless Cafe, where Highway 100 meets the Natchez Trace. We're enjoying wonderful Southern hospitality from the Loveless Cafe. Best of all, we've got some world-class artists ready to perform live right here on this very stage, on the air on WRLT, Lightning 100 FM, over the web at high def video at musiccityroots.com, and here in the Loveless Bar. Welcome to Music City Roots. And now, to get things started, singer, songwriter, all-around heck of a guy, here's Jim Lauderdale.
Thank you, everybody. Hey, let's hear it for Mr. Keith Bilbrand. Yeah. Well, folks, I want to kick things off tonight with a song I wrote with a friend of mine named Robert Hunter. I think he's one of the greatest songwriters that's ever lived, and I had a request to do this one tonight, and this is one of the first songs we wrote together and got to record it with Ralph Stanley, and Robert is having a big birthday here on Saturday. So anyway, I want to send this out to him and his family.
I've been waiting by the way, chill night and heat of day. I can't even count the hours wasted in these ivory towers. When in doubt and deep despair, call for me, I will be there. If I cannot come myself, please don't call on no one else. I won't wait for you in the morning, I will wait for you in the dawn. I'll wait for you, my darling, I'll wait for you till I'm gone. Blood red bird sings in the sky, sun is spinning, my oh my. Struck up on a sparing hill, pray for rain that never will. I will tell you once again, in case you did not hear before, you won't find a better ride, no one else will love you more. I won't wait for you in the morning, I won't wait for you in the dawn. I won't wait for you, my darling, I won't wait for you till I'm gone. If I love you is a crime, I would gladly do my time. Count the days to parole with silver chalk marks on my soul. I will wait on burning sand, wait till you through rivers and make your every dream come true if that is given me to do. I will wait for you in the morning, I will wait for you in the dawn. I will wait for you, my darling, I will wait for you till I'm gone. 7 horses dressed in gray come to bear my heart away. Nothing ventured, nothing lost, I would rather pay the cost. Once upon a winter time, sun broke through the clouds to shine. Summers come, summers go, can't see well, but this I know. I won't wait for you in the morning, I won't wait for you in the dawn. I won't wait for you, my darling, I won't wait for you till I'm gone. I won't wait for you in the morning, I won't wait for you in the dawn. I won't wait for you, my darling, I won't wait for you till I'm gone. Oh, I won't wait for you till I'm gone.
Well, thank you so much. Thank you, and welcome to Music City Roots. And you know, before we go any farther, I want to turn things over to our friend over there in the chat room, Mr. Craig Havockhurst.
Hi, Jim. Hi, folks. Good to see you. Thanks for coming out on a stormy evening. It hailed at our house twice today. Twice in one day. That's odd. Jim, when's that CD coming out? Like next Tuesday?
You know what? You mean the new CD
I wrote all the songs
with Robert Hunter, the Bluegrass CD. Craig, I think it's coming out next Tuesday.
I can confirm that it is. We're going to have a set from you, right? You're going to bring in the Bluegrass band?
I'm bringing the Bluegrass guys here.
It'll be awesome.
To play next week.
Yeah, I've heard the record. It's wonderful. Download cards, I think, are already for sale back there.
You know, I'm not a good self-promoter, but I think they do have the download cards over there at the Nature Conservancy desk, and people can get the CD 6 days early with a bunch of bonus stuff.
All right, good. Now Michelle can give us that foot massage she promised for saying that.
Yeah, all that's right.
So before we go any further, I want to thank a couple people. Moe's Southwest Catering for the wonderful food over here tonight for our band members and our crew members. Moe's Catering does a great job. I can testify, it was delicious. And Blackstone Brewery is supplying our beer over there. Once again, we appreciate them. Go visit that Blackstone Brewery up on West End, one of my favorite places. Good cheeseburgers, too. So tonight's lineup, we're very excited to round out the night with just a really, really important duo back after 20 years of making independent music on. They're back with a phenomenal new album, Foster and Lloyd. Yes. We are going to hear some folk and bluegrass music from a former Ramon, Mr. Tommy Ramone in Uncle Monk. That's going to be crazy. We got some songwriting and some singing from Mr. Doug Paisley from the Great White North in Canada. And another classic Nashville duo coming up right here. Jim?
Ladies and gentlemen, the band you see before you is a Nashville supergroup. It brings together two of the coolest singer-songwriters in town with an amazing rhythm section of local heroes. We're so proud to have them here. Please welcome Tommy Womack, Will Kimbrough, and the band they call Daddy.
Down there, you could have heard a pin drop any time of day. But I'm not sorry, and I'm not sad, though it might take a whole day just to drive out here and visit. Not to worry, no, it's not too bad. Nothing much to do, but that ain't such a hardship, really, is it? When you wait for a car to drive by, just so you can wave hello, hello. Staring at a starry night sky, and you're dreaming of some place to go. Waiting for a car to drive by, just so you can wave hello, hello. Staring at a starry night sky, dreaming of some place to go. Thank you. just so you can wave hello, hello. And you're staring at a starry night sky, dreaming of some place to go.
Thanks, everybody. We call this band Daddy. This is our friend Lisa Oliver Gray singing with us. Paul Griffith on the drums. Mr. Tim Marks on the bass. And over there playing piano and organ and all kind of keyboards, Mr. John Dedrick. This is my friend Tommy Womack from Madisonville, Kentucky, USA, with a little message for you.
And it's a graduation day kind of song here. I read a piece on the news a while back that kids in the job market today, they're just getting out of school. They were all in little league teams that got a trophy whether they won or lost. And they've been brought up, you know, from kindergarten with self-esteem, self-worth, love yourself. And now they're in an office with a boss saying, you have that report on my desk by 8 o'clock tomorrow morning or you hit the street. And they're freaking out. They don't know how to deal with it. So I think that baccalaureate speakers from now on ought to show a little tough love. And this is my version of it. It's called Early to Bed, Early to Rise, Work Like a Dog and Advertise. Your pictures of innocence in your caps and gowns. I hate to be the one to bring you down, but the real world's coming on the midnight train. You're gonna wake up in the morning and everything's changed. Times are hard, you might not survive. 11 little words will keep you alive. Early to bed, dog and advertise. That's right, you heard me. Early to rise. Take a hot shower and open your eyes. You feel like complaining Well, nobody cares. It's time to take charge of your own affairs. Some people work hard, some people don't. Either do for yourself or somebody else won't. You can cut corners and cheat every day. If you wanna push through, there's just one way. Kids, early to bed, early to rise. Work like a dog and advertise. A mouse trap and open a store. Face every day like you're going to war. Get there early and stay there late. Run like an engine, cause the world won't wait. Some son of a gun is on your tail. He's gonna pick up that phone and make that sale. So put on a suit, learn how to smile, learn to go further than the extra mile. Early to bed, early to rise, work like a dog and advertise. Early to bed, early to rise, work like a dog and advertise.
We've got friends here from deep south Alabama and from far north England tonight. And it's so good to be here with Jim Lauderdale and Foster and Lloyd. I have to admit, Foster and Lloyd is the reason I moved to Nashville many, many years ago. So they conned me into it backstage at the Exit Inn, and here we are. So band's called Daddy. This is a song that comes from the road that came between the Exit Inn in 1988 and right now. This is called Wash and Fold. It goes like this. You can stand up and dance in the aisles if you feel the spirit move you. Wash and fold, let me dance before I get too old. Don't be quiet, don't be cold. Meet me down at the wash and fold. Sitting pretty, sitting high and dry. I ain't lonesome, so I won't cry. And I ain't ready for no by and by. Sitting pretty, sitting high and dry. Think I'm ready for my close up now. It's time to barbecue the sacred cow. Hallelujah, mama, don't ask how. Think I'm ready for my close-up now. Think I'm ready. Now I've been blowing bubbles at the laundrette. Show you just how clean a man can get. I'm rubbing, scrubbing till we're soaking wet. Blowing bubbles at the laundrette. Why
wash your teary eyes open, baby. You can struggle, you can scrimp and save, but you can't take it with you to your grave. The wash your teary eyes open, babe. Wash and fold it with me all night long. Ain't nothing dirty, there ain't nothing wrong. You won't be worried about a thing for long. Wash and fold it with me all night long. Let's go swimming in the punching train. Let's go running naked in the Mobile rain. Let's hop a boxcar on the Memphis train. Let's go swimming in the punching train. I've been smoking possum with the chimney sweep. Mississippi River running 3 miles deep. There's a little bitty baby snowing fast asleep. Smoking possum with the chimney sweep. Bring us whiskey, tin, bring us beer. I want to tattoo you and pierce your ears. No ancient Chinese secret here. Bring us whiskey, tin, and bring us here. Right over here, right over here. Fold. Let me dance before I get too old. Now don't be quiet, don't be cold. Meet me down at the washing fold. Hey, let's go swimming in a poncho train. And let's go running naked in a Mobile rain. I'm a boxcar on a Memphis train. Swimming in a poncho train. In the washing fold. Meet me down at the washing fold. Washing fold. Watch and fold, let me dance before I get too old. Watch and fold, meet me down at the watch and fold, watch and fold, let me dance before I get too old.
This is a song, it's entirely true. Every word of this song is true. This is about a girl who lived up the street from me in Madisonville, Kentucky. I met her in 1968 when I was 6 years old, and she set about trying to corrupt me. And all these years later, she has failed. Vicki Smith lived up the street from me. Vicki Smith lived up the street from me.
Vicki Smith was 10 years older than me. I was 6 years old, she was 16. I was 6 years old, she was 16. Vicki Smith was the first pair of hot pants I'd ever seen. Her little brother, Lane Allen, was somebody I played Hot Wheels with. Her little brother, Lane Allen, was somebody I played Hot Wheels with. There was hot pants and Hot Wheels up the street with Lane Allen and Vicki Smith. Vicki Smith smoked cigarettes and swore. Vicki Smith smoked cigarettes and swore. All her dates just honk a horn, never come to the door. Their daddy converted the garage into a den. Their daddy converted the garage into a den. In that den I saw Secretariat win. Vicki Smith married young. Vicki Smith heard that horn honk and off she run. Got D-I-V-O-R-C-E, a J-O-B, and a baby son, praise God.
Rock and roll tonight with the sun still shining outside. We've had all kind of biblical proportions of weather in Tennessee this year. I'm sure many people in the middle part of the country have had it this year. We've had plague of locusts. We've had storms. Oh, Lord. And this is a song about the storms of life itself. This is called You Made Your Bed, You Got to Lay in It. If you would help us sing tonight, since we do have a center aisle and a pew type section here, so we say, you made your bed, you got to lay in it. You made your bed,
lay in it.
I'll tell it. I feel like a rat that the devil wouldn't have in hell. I feel like a rat that the devil wouldn't have in hell. I thought I was above it, but it goes to show, brother, that you never can tell. Oh. Well, I went and broke the heart of a woman that I truly love. Well, I went and broke the heart of a woman that I truly love. Well, it turns out
you made your bed,
got laid.
You made your bed,
got laid.
Oh, made your bed,
got laid.
got a place for you in this world, you gotta stay sand, but my head and my hands say,
say please, baby, please.
When you make your bed,
you gotta lay in it.
Make your bed. You made your bed.
You
don't you know you made your bed?
You
every morning you made your bed.
You
and in the evening you made your bed.
You
Lord, got the place. You got to stay.
For listening to us tonight, we're called Daddy. My friend Tommy Womack, Lisa Oliver Gray, Paul Griffith, Tim Marks, John Dedrick. My name's Will Kimbrough. Great to be here at Music City Roots. yes. That's right. Thank you. Oh, Daddy.
That was so great.
Rock and roll at its finest. Daddy, everybody. Thank you. Or as the infants call them, Dada. Let's hear it again for Daddy.
That's great, man. That's great, man. Thank you.
And now, here's some words from one of our sponsors with Mr. Keith Bilbrey.
Well, thank you very much. I love those words of advice, too. You got to make your bed, you got to lay in it. And that's good, isn't
that's
it?
That's exactly.
I like that. Yes. Well, you may have heard Nissan has joined us as an official partner of Music City Roots. We're proud and excited to have them with us. And you may have heard they're introducing the all-new, totally electric, no-gas Nissan Leaf. And it's pretty amazing. If you haven't test driven one of these babies, believe me, take the time to stop by your local dealer. Take one for a spin. It'll change everything you have ever thought about an electric car. Truly an awesome piece of innovation. We're real proud to have Nissan on board with us, and we sure hope you'll take the time to visit them on Facebook. Type in Nissan Leaf or just Nissan. Whether you test drive a Leaf or just drop them a message on Facebook, be sure you tell them you're a fan of Music City Roots. And thanks for supporting authentic music and a healthy planet. And some of our artists tonight are staying courtesy of Holiday Inn Express, Nashville downtown, and the Nashville Convention and Visitors Bureau. Go to visit musiccity.com to learn more about great things to do and great places to stay when you visit Music City. Now, over to the chat room, and by golly, there's Craig Heverhurst with a couple of guys. Who
thanks,
are those
Keith.
People?
These are fellas going to end your night. I love it. Foster and Lloyd. They need no introductions. Radney Foster, Bill Lloyd. We're thrilled you guys came and shared this new record with us. And, well, you know, its first month of life, just about. Yeah. Month, five
about
weeks.
Month.
Where have you been since it came out? And where have you played? Who's received
We're currently doing a tour of Nashville. We played the Bluebird and out in front of the Bridgestone Arena the other day. So this is our third local date. We're making up T-shirts that have different places, and it's all says Nashville on it.
But we actually have been touring quite a bit down in Texas during the first month since I'm from there and have quite the local following, as they say. So.
Well, the CD is called It's Already Tomorrow. You're going to answer this question a lot as you do this tour, but tell us about what sparked the project and the reunion after about 20 years of doing your own things.
It was really, I think, because of songwriting. I mean, it went back to the basics. We didn't have anybody holding, you know, something over our head and saying, you guys should get back together and make a record. It just kind of fell in place because we did a show for the Americana Music Association that was a benefit show at the Bluebird. And Bill rightly suggested, why don't we write a couple new songs? And then after we did that, then that kind of went so well, we said, well, let's write some more. And
we also put together a band for that event, for that benefit. And I'd been playing with Cheap Trick, and Tom Peterson came and played bass. And Radney's drummer, Keith Brogdon, great friends with Tom, and it just all, so we got a combo out of the deal, too.
And that's pretty much who's playing on the record. That's just, it's pretty much us four, and every now and then we might have a guest or two, a couple, you know, really good guests. But
Sam Bush, Lloyd Green, Beth Nielsen Chapman.
Yeah. So you guys ceased to be a duo in 1990. I think I've got that fact right.
Something
and
like that.
Had you had to like fight the urge to do this again, or were you very clear that you were pursuing your own solo things? What was the dynamic in those years?
I don't know that we were fighting not to do this. I thought we would get back together and do things all the time. It just didn't seem like it settled into anything. There was always sort of a situation where, you know, even when I might have gone, hey, I wonder if we should do, you know, Bill was in a band called the Sky Kings at the time. So it just, there was all these different situations where, you know, it kind of didn't make any sense.
Right.
And then all of a sudden it made sense.
Okay, fair enough. Timing is everything. Well, y'all have pursued so many varied projects over these years. Bill as a sideman, a contributor to other projects, a producer, a power pop artist, but I want to ask about, now that you've got these years of perspective on this period when you had hits on the radio and you were part of that country music thing and some very interesting times, really. I mean, the radio was more diverse, was quite diverse then. How do you reflect on that those years when you actually had hits versus the years when people knew you, had the critics loved you, you were playing interesting gigs, but it wasn't like you could see your name on a chart in Billboard. I mean, what's the difference?
Well, for me, that was kind of a blur, to be honest. We were staff songwriters who got a record deal, and we both, I'd made one independent record, and Radney was probably on his way to making his first solo record when we got signed as a duo. So we just postponed all that. And
whose idea was the duo? Where did that come from?
Well, it kind of came out of our songwriting.
Came out of writing, really, yeah.
It came out of songwriting because the songs that we were writing together were the songs that were getting cut by other artists.
Interesting.
And
the other is that Bill had a buddy at RCA Records, and he put his new record that he just made on one side of a cassette and said, hey, I've been writing all these country things with this guy, Radney Foster, on the other side. And that thing got passed around all over, and they were like, right. That's a whole thing. You know,
people heard the songs instead of just cutting the songs, they heard it like it was a project.
Oh, I see, right. So the music at the time had some Everly Brothers kind of feeling, it had some Birds and Beatles influence. It was not George Strait, you know, and so how did it get received?
But there was a healthy dose of Buck Owens and
right?
Honky Tonk yeah. kind of stuff in there.
And Buck Owens and the Everly Brothers, a lot of that.
Yeah.
And a lot of rockabilly, I agree with that.
Yeah. So.
You know, at the time, I mean, it was blowing up like wildfire, you know, I mean, it was unbelievable. It really was such a blur. You know, you go in, you make a record, you're pretty much, you know, in anonymity, you know, except in the local bar scene around here in Nashville. You go in, your first record goes to number one. I mean, we were going into, you know, play venues and clubs and opening for Roy Orbison and for Carl Perkins and for the wow. Beach Boys and all these people and you know, we were selling out shows and people were digging our music. It was a really neat time, but it was a blur. I had a routing thing, or you had a routing thing that showed like, I don't know, like 180 gigs in a year or something crazy.
What's cool is now we remember different things now. Hey, do you remember? No.
No.
Do you remember? No.
No.
We remember different stuff about. So we're filling each other in on what we did.
We're filling each other's gaps in.
20 years ago.
Well, folks, there's the new record. It's already tomorrow. And there's three Foster and Lloyd records back there in the old catalog world. Foster and Lloyd, Faster and Louder, and Versions of the Truth, all worth picking up. A great career, if maybe a little too short. But glad you're back and making this music. Foster and Lloyd, folks.
Thank you, Craig.
Thanks very much, man.
See you later on the stage.
Yes, and she gets to have the brown microphone.
Thank you so very much.
Yeah, let's...
Again, well, hello, everyone. I'm Allie Sutton, the Vietti Chili Girl, and here is a word from our sponsor. Can you hurry up? For goodness sakes, my stomach aches for Vietti love. Vietti love. Vietti love. I can't wait to fill my plate with Vietti love. Don't want no chicken and dumplings. Don't want no apple pie. Ain't nothing but
Well, I am so excited about our next guest. He is a songwriter out of Toronto whose second album, Constant Companion, had leading music press like Rolling Stone and Mojo reaching for superlatives. He's been acclaimed for his sparse, straightforward style, and his album collaborators included famed artist Leslie Feist and the band's keyboard genius, Garth Hudson. It's a real pleasure to have him with us on our Music City Roots stage. Please say hello to Mr. Doug Paisley.
Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you so much. At least in terms of numbers, that's a hard act to follow. And that was quite an exciting band, too. So I hope you don't mind just one guy and a guitar for a little while. I came all the way from Canada to sing for you, and it's a pleasure and an honor to be here. I'd like to play a song I wrote a while ago, and ever since I recorded it, I've had a lot of people come up to me and say that the person that I'm singing about in this song is all too familiar. It's called No One But You. I've seen you stumble, I've seen you fall, I've seen you brought down, feathers and all. Pick yourself up for the ones that you call your best friends. I know you've been fighting what we can't see. Sometimes it takes many faces to be. It takes a time and a place to be free, but in the end, so cruel to someone like you, no one but you. Who would make the rules for the things that you do, no one but you. This morning, I looked to the sky. I thought of all of the time that's been by. But it didn't matter how hard we tried, because in the end, who would be so cruel to someone like you? No one but you. Who would make the rules for the things that you do? No one but you. Thank you very much. Well, sometimes being in love is a wonderful thing, and sometimes you just gotta pull through. And this is a song about the latter half of it. It's called We Weather. Near-death car crash drew us together. The quiet nights at home that tore us apart, but we held on somehow through stormy weather, wondering whether we'd weather the love in our hearts. But we weathered the sunshine, we weathered the storms, the cold nights together, we stayed close and warm. And I'm better beside you, though I'm tattered, I'm torn. And I know you need me when you're weary and worn. Mm-hmm. Sometimes we're old friends, we're laughing together. And sometimes we're mules with burdens to bear. And sometimes we're fighting, and I'm watching you thinking how times without a warning, the darkness is there. But we weathered the sunshine, we weathered the storms, the cold nights together, we stayed close and warm. And I'm better beside you, though I'm tattered, I'm torn, and I know you need me when you're weary and worn. But you're on the telephone from somewhere else, saying you're just trying to get free. And I'm stoned, I'm senseless, got no feeling for the pain. It's not who we set out to be. But we weathered the sunshine, we weathered the storms, the cold nights together, we stayed close and warm. And I'm bitter beside you, though I'm tattered, I'm torn, and I know you need me when you're weary and worn.
Thank you very much. Well, a lot of the music that I listen to comes right out of this area, so being from so far away, it's really exciting to be down here, and especially to be playing here. And this is a song I wrote that's, I think, about as much of a country song as I ever wrote. It's called If I Wanted To.
Except for the old highway, and after so long I've got to get gone. There's nothing you could do or say that could make me stay. Not even if I wanted to, not even if I would. And after what you put me through, I don't see why I should. You go your way and I'll go mine. You and I are better as two. You can be sure that I won't change my mind. That's one thing I wouldn't do. Not even if I wanted to. If I wanted to, not even if I would, and after what you put me through, I don't see why I should. You go your way and I'll go mine. You and I are better as two. You can be sure that I won't change my mind. That's one thing I wouldn't do. Not even if I wanted to. Thank you very much. This is a song I wrote about a bat that I found outside a cabin that I was living in. And it was at a time when I was really feeling kind of low and looking for some good news. And I saw this bat and I imagined it sleeping there and waking up in the night and flying away. But there was something about it that didn't look quite right. And I wasn't sure if it was even still alive at all. And the sun went down and the night was long, and I was wondering the whole time if I was gonna wake up in the morning and find it there or find it gone. And this is the song I wrote while I was waiting. She slept through the day and she slept through the night, and I found her there in the morning in a breath of frost with her eyes shut tight. I have found her there in the morning. I have found her there in the morning. Well, the rushing streams have breached their banks and the whole wide world is waking, and the ice has gone down into the ground, and the whole wide world is waiting, and the whole wide world is waiting. Well, she slept through the day and she slept through the night, and I found her there in the morning in a breath of frost with her eyes shut tight. I found her there in the morning. I have found her there in the morning. Well, the rushing streams have breached their banks, and the whole wide world is waiting, and the ice has gone down into the ground, and the whole wide world is waking. I walked on the road beneath the stars, I hung my head and shivered. I walked the road beneath the stars, where all will be. Where all will be delivered. I sat by the edge of the firelight, and the sun crept from the embers. I prayed alone in the dark of night that my soul would be remembered, that my soul would be remembered. Well, she slept through the day and she slept through the night, and I found her there in the morning in a breath of frost with her eyes shut tight. I found her there in the morning. I found her there in the morning.
Thank you so much. And thanks so much to Music City Roots for being such a fantastic venue here. I'm going to play one more song for you, and it's been a real pleasure and an honor to play for you, so thank you so much. And this last song is called At the End of the Day.
Of the day that I'm fading away, I'm gonna get by, I'm gonna get through. When the well runs dry, I'm gonna cross to you. There's no up, there's no down, and there's no way around. At the end of the day, your heart, it is worn, you're a bleeding machine. A ghost hand lifts you up out of your dream. See the sunlight combed on the shapes at the frame. At the end of the day, I'm gonna get by. I'm gonna get through. When the well runs dry, I'm gonna cross to you. There's no up, there's no down, and there's no way around. At the end of the day, thank you so much, everybody. It's been my great pleasure to play for you. I'll see you again sometime. Have a wonderful evening.
Doug Paisley, everybody. That was great, Doug. Thank you so much for being here. Doug Paisley. Well, folks, we've started a new tradition here at Music City Roots. Every season, we're throwing a party at one of our fans' homes. Now, you can watch the past two in the Roots Video Archives at the website, but guess what? This summer's Music City Roots House Party is up for grabs. Now, check this out. If you win this contest, the amazing bluegrass artist Frank Sullivan and Dirty Kitchen will not only come to your house to play music, but Frank is a gourmet chef, and he'll go shopping for fresh organic groceries at Whole Foods Market.
Whoa.
And cook dinner for you and 25 friends before the show, with Blackstone Brewery throwing in some freshly brewed ale. Now, this could be the block party of the summer, Keith, in your neighborhood. And the Roots Film crew will live stream the whole thing for the world to see. Look for the contest link and all the details at musiccityroots.com. Now, listen to Mr. Keith Bilbrey with a word from one of our fine sponsors.
Thank you very much, Jim Lauderdale. We're so proud to have these folks in the Root family. Authentic, organic music is a perfect match for organic food from Whole Foods Market. Now, these folks seek out the finest natural and organic foods available, maintain the strictest quality standards in the industry, and have an unshakable commitment to sustainable and local agriculture. Now, add to that the excitement and fun they bring to grocery shopping, and you start to get a sense of what Whole Foods Markets are all about. They started with one store in 1980 in Austin, Texas. Today, they're the world's leader in natural and organic foods with more than 300 stores in North America and the United Kingdom, including four stores in the great state of Tennessee. Now, yesterday, we were out at the new Franklin location on McEwen Drive, broadcasting another Music City Roots lunchtime concert with Tommy Ramone and Uncle Monk. And you were about to hear tonight if you missed it. So don't feel bad. You can check out the performance on our website, musiccityroots.com. Please show your support to our good friends at Whole Foods Market all over the country and locally here in Green Hills and Franklin. Tell them thanks for supporting the authentic music of Music City Roots. We'd also like to thank our friends at the Nashville Scene. If you want to know what's happening in and around Music City, do what I do. Look for a fresh copy at local newsstands every Thursday, or just visit NashvilleScene.com. You're listening to Music City Roots on Nashville's independent radio, Lightning 100 WRLT, Franklin, Nashville, 100.1 on your FM dial here in Nashville. And of course, we're broadcasting live from the big old barn out behind the world-famous Loveless Cafe at the intersection of Highway 100 and the historic Natchez Trace Parkway. When you're in Nashville, you can get breakfast, lunch, and dinner in true Southern comfort style at the Loveless 364 days a year. Now, if you're not lucky enough to be here in town, well, you can get a basket of Tennessee's finest comfort food sent anywhere in the world, from homemade jams and jellies to Miss Carol Faye's famous biscuit mix. Folks from Martha Stewart to Vince Gill have all called them the best in the world. Take a look at lovelesscafe.com. Now, Craig Everhurst, what's going on over in the chat room?
Thank you, sir. I appreciate it. Well, what's going on over here is the two fellas you heard singing and playing at the beginning of our show, Will Kimbrough, Tommy Womack of Daddy. The two voices, but far from being the entirety of the band. I gather when you put this together, you wanted it to be a band.
Yeah, we did. We had people in mind, and everybody who we had in mind said yes.
Said yeah. Well, let's talk about these guys. You have Paul Griffith back there on the drums and John Dederick on keys, and round it out for us. Who are, just give us a little background for those who are not already steeped in the Nashville music scene. Who are these guys?
Well, Paul Griffith is one of the greatest drummers in the world, simply put. He was born and raised, he was born in England, but he grew up in Algiers, Louisiana, and that greasy, funky New Orleans, Louisiana kind of drumming, he's got that in his bones. And you can't really name drop with him because he's played for everybody. He's one of the most in-demand session drummers in the world. Would you like to explain about one another?
Well, tonight we had Tim Marks playing bass, but the original bass player is Dave Jakes, who we asked to be in the band despite knowing that he plays with John Prine, and he's played with Emmylou Harris, and on and on and on, Patty Griffin. And John Dederick is just another person who we were just enamored of his playing, the keyboard player. And he's out with Alison Krauss right now, so there you go. It's
but
crazy.
He made it in. Well, it struck me that there was a certain bit of a similarity with the Foster and Lloyd on the bill tonight, because y'all are two striking individual artists who get together and have something else happen, just like Bill and Radney are. But you guys were in a band many years ago as well, and kind of came back and got this together again. But then I was surprised, Will, to hear you say that Foster and Lloyd had been a factor in your moving here. What was that story?
I was in a band called Will and the Bushmen, and we moved up here from Alabama. We were playing the Exit Inn in Nashville in the late 80s, and at the time, Foster and Lloyd had a number one single, and Steve Earle had a big hit, and Lyle Lovett and Nancy Griffith and a bunch of other people whose music I really liked were country hits. And so they were encouraging me to move to town, and I was like, man, I'm moving to this town, and I still live in this town, so good. I met Tommy here.
And Tommy, tell us a bit about the Biscuits, the band that you guys were in years and years ago.
I was in Government Cheese, and Will was in Will and the Bushmen, and they were both falling apart at the same time. And I moved to Nashville in April of 92, and I scored an acoustic opening gig for King Bub at 12th and Porter. And Grimey, everybody knows who Grimey is, I guess, invited me to a jam in a basement with Will and Tommy Meyer and himself. And we had one great jam and thought, well, instead of opening acoustically this gig, let's have these four guys do it, you know. And we did, and that was the first Biscuits gig, and it commenced two of the happiest years of my life. And we made one record on Oh Boy Records, John Prine's label, and I'm from Kentucky. So to have been on the same record label with John Prine, there's just not words for it.
Well, I just can't emphasize enough, folks, if you start to scratch the background of these guys, the guys in their band, you start to, the tendrils go out, and the whole history of the last 25 years in Nashville is, you know, 1 or 2 degrees of separation away. It's really extraordinary. So the current CD from Daddy is For a Second Time.
Right.
A couple years old now. I understand you're both starting to get ready to do solo projects. Just fill us in on what y'all are kind of up to.
Yeah, we're working on, Tommy's finished a new record, and I'm sort of halfway through one. I'm on tour with Emmylou Harris this summer, which I'm really happy to be. And, more tendrils, and
for sure.
And so, just we have an idea for a new Daddy record, and we just need like a week together to write the songs. Yeah. So we just got to make that happen.
Tom, you got a project coming? Can we say when?
I have a record finished. It's my last solo record was called There I Said It, and this is the follow-up to it. Thank you, person.
Yes, sir.
The follow-up is called Now What, and we're shooting for October for a release. And other than that, I'm following the Casey Anthony trial fairly closely.
It's the hottest show of the summer.
You know it.
Well, fellas, we appreciate having you here. Anytime you want to come back, we love the sound of the band. It's great to kick off with some real rock and roll. I'll just call him Daddy. One more time for Daddy. Thanks a lot. Will Kimbrough, Tommy Womack, we appreciate y'all.
And Craig Heavenhurst!
Jim Lovett.
Yeah, hey, folks. Now, the Ramones might not have been a perfect fit for Music City Roots, but this Ramone is. Tommy Ramone was, in fact, a founder of that great rock and roll band. And later, he became their manager and producer. And in recent years, Tommy has turned his attention to folk music, and the result is the duo taking the stage right now. Here is Uncle Monk.
Thanks so much, Jim. All right, this is Claudia from Tommy. We're Uncle Monk, and we're going round the bend. One, two, one. Drop me a line, send me a note, get this python off my throat. Coming round the bend. You get mad, not get better. You get bad, not get better. Coming round the bend. Coming round midnight. Coming round the bend. Coming round the old back road again. Know the pressure's big, fat train. Don't wanna be late, miss that train. Coming round the bend. You're in my field just like a baby born. Coming round the bend. Bring your sorrows, I'll bring mine. But those sorrows have a real good time. Going round the bend. Coming around the old back road again. Know the pressure's big, fat train. Don't wanna be late and miss that train. Coming around then. Gonna be there in my field just like a little baby born. Coming around then. Bring your sorrows, I'll bring mine. Dust the sorrows, have a real good time. Thank you. It's Round the Bend. That's the first song off our record entitled Uncle Monk. Okay. All right. Here's a song. This is dedicated to all the people that have been mean to me. Mean to me. Why are you mean to me? Why can't you let things be? Let us be friends. Maybe I'll call you up. We can go have a talk. Maybe a dinner. jealous of me? Are you mad at me? Are you fond of me? Or do you hate me? Why are you mean to me? Oh, so mean to me. Why can't you let things be? Let us be friends. Thank you so much. All right. Well, it's been a rainy day today, so we'd like to bring out the sunshine with a little song called Sunshine. One, two, three, four. Up a little because it sounds better that way. Okay, now I would like to introduce you to Mr. Endicott, the boss man. Yeah.
yells at me when I'm late. He yells at me on my coffee break. Look out. Work to do, Mr. Endicott. Got a fake all day through, Mr. Endicott. I am talking on the phone with my friends. My lunch break. Is there any guy? Oh, don't ask me where have I been. My paycheck, it's very thin. In your breath, it's allergen.
Here's our little punk rock folk waltz that we do called Home Sweet Reality. One, two, three, two, two, three.
Government grant the way to long home sweet reality, leave me alone. Day to day by. Want to go home, home, sweet reality, leave me alone. Can't be to see government loan. Home, sweet reality, leave me alone. Have no funds, feeling so poor. Home, sweet reality, leave me alone. Home, sweet reality, can set you free. Start up your life, or let you. Lord, home, sweet reality, leave me alone. Count it out, everyone knows. Home, sweet reality, leave me alone. TV flickers a slick, a flash. Home, sweet reality, leave me alone. Endless gossip, mindless trash. Home, sweet reality. Thank you.
Thank you. All right, this next song is called Cyclone, which is a famous roller coaster in Brooklyn, in New York, where we come from. It goes like this. Just a roller coaster. Get on and ride. No one's gonna know what's on the other side. 16 turns, you meet a big hole. Give a little whistle. Thank you.
Well, thank you. We are so honored to be here. Thanks. What a great show to be on. Thanks so much. And we're Uncle Monk, Claudia, Tommy, and pretty soon we'll be long gone. One, two, one. Long gone. It's finally been long gone. What do you cry? This is why I'm a baby. Why I'm gone, long gone. I have tried to make you happy. Still say you've done me wrong. So I'm giving up, my darling. I'll be gone, long gone. Shed no tears, they mourn a tone. For my bags, back from travel, I'll be gone, long gone. Long gone, if I'm leaving, long gone. What do you cry? This is why I want a baby. Thanks so much. Thank you.
Uncle Monk. Thank you so much. Thank you. Uncle Monk, everybody. Welcome to Nashville. Thank y'all so much. Folks, our Roots vision is all about creating a community between fans, bands, and brands. The sponsors that make it all possible get this all together and make it possible for us to listen and to be here. So please support the great sponsors of the show. And now here's Mr. Keith Bilbrey to talk about our friends that are saving the planet.
For instance, the Nature Conservancy. Well, here in Tennessee, it's a good time of year to enjoy your nature indoors. The Nature Conservancy invites you to see a beautiful exhibit currently running at the Parthenon. The show's called Missing Nature, and the large-scale color photos on display, they are just absolutely gorgeous. They're the work of Music City Roots regular named Byron Jajorgian. Now, you may remember Byron on our stage during a Nature Conservancy benefits show a few months back talking about the Tennessee coneflower, how the Conservancy brought it back from the endangered species list, and how his photo of one ended up on the cover of the phone book in our state. Byron's been a member of the Nature Conservancy for more than 20 years and has taken literally hundreds of thousands of photos on Nature Conservancy preserves around the world. The lush green images currently on exhibit are at the Parthenon, and they're all from lands and waters right here in Tennessee, protected by our hardworking friends at the Nature Conservancy. And the exhibit's title suggests there are places we should surely miss if the Nature Conservancy had not saved them. This photo exhibit's open at the Nashville Parthenon Tuesday through Saturday through August 20th. Don't miss Missing Nature. And if you're in our live audience tonight, be sure and stop by the Nature Conservancy table over there and sign up for their free e-newsletter every month. It'll update you on what the Nature Conservancy's doing here in Tennessee and all around the world. For those listening at home, sign up at mynature.org, mynature.org. We'd like to give a shout out to our friends at Digitech, the official office equipment provider here at Music City Roots. Take a look at these beautiful programs for a sample of their quality. You can find them at digitechllc.com. Speaking of quality, I see Craig Heverhurst over there.
Thank you, Keith. I appreciate it. Going to get to talk to the fella you just heard, Mr. Tommy Ramone. Yeah. Say hello to Tommy.
Hey, hi, Craig. Thank you.
Founder of Uncle Monk. How'd this band get together, and why'd you choose that name? I probably get asked that quite a lot, but I'm really curious.
It's a name I had for like 25 years. I just thought it liked the way it sounded, you know. Plus, we're big fans of Thelonious Monk and the painter Edward Munch, and so it's Uncle Monk.
There you go. Thelonious Monk from my home state of North Carolina, to many people's surprise. I'm a fan, too. Tell me about your origins of your love of folk music and traditional music, because it's not what we would have heard in 1977.
Yeah, my father was a huge country music fan, and my older brother would, when I was a child, would bring home records from the library of folk music and string band music and bluegrass, and so I grew up listening to this, along with rock and roll, you know. It was all happening in our house, you know, throughout my life.
Well, I gotta ask then, how did you get led as a young guy into the most, I mean, at the time, kind of the most extreme end of rock and roll that was happening? What led you away from the acoustic thing and into, you know, kind of quintessential punk rock?
Well, actually, I was into folk music first, but then the Beatles came along. And everybody, including all my friends, plugged in and we started playing rock and roll, you know? So everybody wanted to be the Beatles. And later on, you know, when I was got to be my 20s, I thought that the music was getting very stale and stagnant on the radio and stuff like that. And I was longing back to the sound of the late 50s with Little Richard and Chuck Berry and Jerry Lee Lewis and Elvis and stuff like that. So we decided to that's kind of how the idea of the Ramones sort of started to happen. We wanted to strip down rock and roll to its basics and sort of twisted it around a little and add new things to it. That's kind of how that came about.
Wow. You acted as the band's manager for a time, producer, and drummer, and you were there at the founding. Is it safe to say that you were in some way tried to guide the vision of the band, that you were somebody who had a strong sense of where they needed to go and did some of the pushing?
Yes, I knew these guys from my neighborhood, and I just thought they would be... They had something special that they would be exciting. So I encouraged them to put a band together. So they came to a rehearsal. I arranged the rehearsal. And to my amazement, they showed up with original songs. And these were the most unique, bizarre, strange songs I've ever heard. So right away I said, oh, wow, there's something special here, along with what I already thought was going to be a great thing.
Right. Why did you move from the band to the behind-the-scenes role? I'm curious.
Well, actually, no, it was the other way around. I started as their manager.
Okay.
And we were looking for drummers for them. And I was trying to explain to people who were auditioning for the drummer role what was needed. And they just couldn't get it. And even though I never played drums in my life before, I would sit down and show them what should be done. And finally the band said, why don't you play drums?
Right.
So that's how I ended up being the drummer also.
Well, let's fast forward to this project you've got going now. When did you two start the Uncle Monk duo, and why? What was going on in your life that said it's time to go out on the road and play some folk
songs?
Yeah,
it was about 1990. Originally, it was a trio. It was a rock and roll trio with a drummer. But we lost the drummer, and we started adding bluegrass and old-time music elements into what we were doing, and we just loved it. And we just unplugged and just turned acoustic, and it started sounding better and better. We were having more and more fun, and that's how it's been since.
Fantastic. So you have one self-titled CD out, the Uncle Monk CD is out, and you said there's a new one in the works. You're really kind of actively working on one.
That's right. We're working on that right now, and that should be ready by the end of the year, the next Uncle Monk record.
Fantastic. Tommy's also been a producer, worked in, an engineer, worked with the Talking Heads, did the Tim album by The Replacements, which is a definite favorite of mine. So a really varied career. I wish we could talk all night, but time does not allow. Thanks for coming. Tommy Ramone.
Thanks, Greg. Thank you.
Tommy, thanks so much for being here with us tonight, Tommy. It's a great thrill to have you here. Well, folks, you met them in the interview earlier, and now it's time to hear them. They came together in 1985 and surprised everybody by becoming the first duo in country music history to see their first single skyrocket to number one. That was Crazy Over You, and it sparked one of the coolest careers of its era. Now, Radney and Bill went their own ways in 1990, and both have had remarkable solo careers. But the tug of their old sound was too much, and now they've come back together to make their first new album in more than 20 years. We're thrilled to welcome them here tonight to Music City Roots. Let's hear it for Foster and Lloyd.
Title cut of our brand new record. old one, but a good one.
Hope you remember this. It's called What Do You Want From Me? This time.
Last time, baby, you slammed the door. You walked out, I walked the floor. Now you're back to mess my mind. Baby, what do you want from me this time? We had love, but not for long. That wasn't and now it's gone. Last time I got left behind. Baby, what do you want from me this time? What do you want from me this time? What do you think you're gonna find? I'm not trying to be unkind. Well, what do you want from me this time? Our love, and it's a rise and fall. But now it don't hurt at all. Now my love's not near as blind. Baby, what do you want from me this time? What do you want from me this time? What do you think you're gonna find? I'm not trying to be unkind. But what do you want from me this time? You say things that change, but that's pretending. Baby, love don't always have a happy ending. Baby, what do you want from me this time? What do you think you're gonna find? I'm not trying to be unkind. But what do you want from me this time? What do you want from me this time? What do you think you're gonna find? I'm not trying. From me this time. What do you want from me this time?
Part, but we like that song. Let's introduce the band real quick. Over here on the bass guitar, Mike Vargo. And
you back on the drums, Mr. Keith Brogdon on the skins, if you will.
Keith made our record with us and also designed the cover.
Multi-talented young gentleman he is. This is another new song off of the record, and it's a ballad, and it's sweet. It's how I feel. So. If it hadn't been for you, I might have never let my dreams die young. You know, I'm going to start that over. That's totally wrong. It's live radio, and I can do it right in front of God and everybody on my hometown, Nashville, Tennessee. Nothing. If it hadn't been for you, I might have let my reckless dreams die young and come undone. If it hadn't been for you, I might have never dropped the reins and let them run. If it hadn't been for you, I might have never learned to let go and live the way we live. Let love teach me how to share the moments I didn't know how to give. But baby, I know soul and a better man. I wouldn't know love the way I do if it hadn't been for you. If it hadn't been for you, I might have never bought a ticket for the ride. I learned to love the twists and turns, the ups and downs with you by my side. But baby, I know that I am a lucky soul. Rodney Foster.
All right, here's another song from the new record. sometimes you just can't. Even at our age, we cannot stop from telling a bad joke. And even in a song lyric. This one's called "That's What She Said."
What she said.
When I'm looking for a good time, I'll wink at her and throw another punchline.
That's what she said.
A good bad joke, hard to ignore. It's just my way of knocking on her door. Give it a rest, give it a break. She said she had all she can take. She's heard my single and my double entendre, but it ain't funny no longer. I can laugh till I'm blue in the face, but it don't make it right. Oh, that's what she said. That's what she said last night. Chicken might be finger licking, but it messes up the kitchen. That's what she said. Poison ivy leaves you twitching. scratch you while it's itching.
That's what she said.
That's the kind of stuff makes me smile. Drives her crazy, but it drives her wild. She said, give it a rest, give it a break. She says she's had all she can't take. She's heard my single and my double entendre. But it ain't funny no longer. I can laugh till I'm blue in the face, but it don't make it right. Oh, that's what she said. That's what she said last night.
That's what she said. Thank you. All right, here's another one from this new album called It's Already Tomorrow. Find it right back there if you want it. Do they loud out here? If they do, you should dance. I'm just saying. I'm just saying. Hit it. Come on now.
It's our first number one record.
Kind of heavy relocate my life in a pinch. He said my
were jumping rather quick. They had a lost in the lead. I wanna see your toss a twangin' here, bangin' here, jangle like a serious they're talking to me. Play a little faster, play a little louder, make some noise, the promise boys, and see if we get it out. Won't you help me rock away a memory? Play a little faster and a louder for me. Till I might forget a fist and then I'll be fine. If you speed it up again, I might forget I left my baby behind. If you pull me to the bar, put a dollar in the jar, you gotta help me get this girl on my mind. Play a little faster, play a little louder, make some noise, promise boys to see, forget it. Won't you help me rock away a memory? Play a little faster and louder for me. 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 Faster and louder, 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 faster and louder.
Thank you. Rodney Foster.
Bill Lloyd for Foster and Lloyd. Thank you so much.
Foster and Lloyd. That was putting the scald on it, folks. Foster and Lloyd. Oh, yeah. Oh. Hey, I want to thank, let's give a big thanks to the Blackstone Brewery lineup tonight. Daddy. Doug Paisley. Uncle Monk. Foster and Lloyd. Next week, the Westbound Rangers, Sarah Jaros, Becky Schlegel, Tiller's Folly, and our very own Jim Lauderdale.
Yeah.
Keith?
Speaking of Jim Lauderdale, Jim Lauderdale's got a new record coming out. Did you know that? I shouldn't say record, a CD. And the new album's called Reason and Rhyme. It's going to be available everywhere on June 21st, but it's a very big but. Right now, you can place your order for the record and get a limited edition merchandise at jimlauderdale.com. All pre-orders come with an instant download package that includes two songs from the album and two exclusive tracks from memorable Jim Lauderdale performances right here at Music City Roots. More information, visit jimlauderdale.com. Which leads us to the question, folks, what has your financial institution done for you lately? Well, for the past 5 years, Ascend Federal Credit Union's returned more than $26 million to its members, coupled with low rates on mortgages and auto loans, free electronic services to help you manage your money, and free budget assistance. Ascend just simply gives you more. And Ascend is a nonprofit financial co-op owned and operated by its members. They have a volunteer board of directors that works hard to keep fees low, rates competitive, and keep the credit union moving forward. So what's your financial institution giving you? Well, there's never been a better time to be a member of Ascend Federal Credit Union. Spread the word. To find out more, visit ascendfcu.org, and you can also visit your nearest Ascend Financial Center or call 800-342-3086. Personal financial service that aims higher. Ascend Federal Credit Union, raising possibilities. Ascend is an equal housing lender, federally insured by the NCUA, and membership is limited. Thanks to our sponsors, Nissan, Whole Foods Market, Vietti Chili, Ascend Federal Credit Union, The Nature Conservancy, and to the folks from Sound Image for providing the first-class live sound reinforcement you enjoy every week here at the bar. And they're a proud sponsor of this final segment. We call it the Loveless Jam, where we never know what our guests are going to surprise us with.
Jim Lauderdale, what surprise do you have for us tonight?
Well, I'll tell you what surprise we've got cooking up for you here. Keith, let's give another hand to Keith Bilbrey,
well,
first of all.
Thank you.
And this one, we throw out this Loveless jam kind of in honor of everybody who works here at the Loveless, and our very own Mr. Bahama Tom Morales.
Yeah, I've
heard
of him.
And we thought since Tommy Ramone was here tonight, we were going to do a Ramone song called I Want to Be Sedated.
One, two, three, four.
Nothing to do and nowhere to go. I wanna be sedated. Just take me to the airport and get me on a plane. Just take me anywhere before I go insane. I can't control my fingers, I can't control my brain. Oh no, 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 no. Put me in a wheelchair, get me on a plane. Hurry, 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 before I go insane. Can't control my fingers, can't control my brain. Oh no.
This is a production of Hang Dye Media. Executive producers Todd Mayo and John Walker. I'd like to give a big shout out to all our new friends on the island of Eleuthera in the Bahamas. We're looking forward to big things in the future. And of course to Fred Buck and all our friends at Lightning 100. Thanks for being a true voice of independence in Nashville. We're glad you joined us this week for Music City Roots live from the Loveless Cafe. I'm Keith Bilbrey, and from the edge of Music City, good night.
Hang Dye.